So here whole body plethysmography. In this case, the whole body plethysmography, the patients are asked them to sit or stand inside a airtight chamber, and they will ask them to inhale or exhale to a particular volume, usually up to the functional residual capacity level. Up to that one, they will ask them to inhale air and exhale air. That is, they will ask them to take a maximum inhaling and a maximum exhaling. So here it is a chamber, that is, it's having a shutter, and then it's drop across the breathing tube. So here that is contains some breathing tube. In this case, the patients are sitting inside the chamber. You can see that that is a breathing tube is there. In that, they will ask the patient to inhale and exhale up to the FRC level, that is up to the functional residual capacity level. So this is a typical diagram you are seeing here. So usually the plethysmography is used to measure changes in volume in different parts of the body, and this test may be done to check the blood clots also in the arms or legs. So here it is also done in a measure how much air we can hold in our lungs, and here they are using the pencil pulse volume recording instrument. This is one of the type of test used to record the entire lung volume and lung capacity. So here the plethysmography, we can say that it is an instrument for measuring changes in volume within an organ or a whole body. Usually it provides resulting from fluctuation in about of how much amount of blood or air it contains in our body. So here the plethysmography word is have been derived from a Greek. Plethysmos means it is called as a increasing or enlarging volume due to the air when it's become full, and the other term name is called graphos. Grapho means to write or a record. Okay, the entire thing plethysmographic is called recording the filling volume in terms of increasing and enlarging criteria. So here the pulmonary plethysmographies are commonly used to measure the functional residual capacity, that is FRC of the lungs, and also the lung volumes we can measure when muscles of respiratories are relaxed. These plethysmography can also measure the total lung capacity. Here in a traditional plethysmography, it is like a body box. There the test is subjected, or patient is placed inside a sealed chamber. The size of the small, it is like a small telephone booth, and with a single mouthpiece is connected to the patient mouth. At the end of the normal expiration, the mouthpiece is closed. The patient is asked to make an inspiratory effort in a maximum level. As the patient tries inhale maneuver, which looks and feels like a panting. That is called as a short breathing. Short breathing is called a panting. And during that time, the lungs expand and decreases the pressure within the lungs. This one, when lung volume increases, this in turn increases the pressure within the box. Since it closed a system and the volume of box compartment has decreased to accommodate the new volume of subject. We can have that cabinless plethysmography also. The patient is seated next to the desktop testing device and inserted the mouthpieces into the patient mouth. Then the patient is asked a series of normal tidal breaths for approximately 1 second, 1 minute. In this tidal breathing, a series of rapid interruptions occurs with a shutter opening and closing. Then it measures the pressures and volume of a lung. So what is a methodological approach they are using it here? Here we can know that when a temperature increases, the pressure is increased, the volume will be decreased. That we are seeing in a graph. And the mass is also pushed to the upward. The volume is indicated in liter, 1 liter, 2 liter, 3 liter, 4 liter, 5 liter, 6 liter in a blue color. And the pressure and temperature have been monitored by the pressure gauge and a temperature sensor. So here when the temperature increases, pressures also increase. And these respiratory system entire one is can be done according to the Boyle's law principle. So here the Boyle's law is used to calculate the unknown volume within the lungs. First the lung, there is a changes in volume of chest is computed. Then the initial pressure of box times and its volume is considered equal to unknown pressure after expansions times. And also the unknown new volume also can be predicted. Once the new volume is found, the original volume is minus with the new volumes and its changes in volume in the box. This one can changes in volume in the chest also. So with this information they are finding out the lung volume. So Boyle's law used to determine the original volume of gas in the chest. The initial volume is known as unknown volume. With some times the initial pressure is equal to final times the final pressure. And they are finding out the starting from this principle, it can be shown that the functional residual capacity is a function of changes in volume and the pressure given by the below equation. That means here functional residual capacity, which is equal to K suffix V, some constant volume which is multiplied by partial pressure, the R differential pressure in the box, divided by differential pressure in the mouth. That means FRC, which is equal to KV, some constant volume into change in volume in the box divided by change in pressure in the mouth. Here KV is nothing but a pressure of barometric. Here this equation, which is a difference between full and empty lungs, can be measured which is used to access the diseases and airway passage restrictions. Example and obstructive diseases can be shown the increased FRC because some air do not empty normally, and also we can measure the restrictive disease there the FRC shows a decreased function. So the body plethysmography, we can say that the body plethysmography method here the body plethysmography is a particularly appropriate for the patient who have a air space which do not communicate with the bronchial trees. In such that way the patient, they are asking to go for helium dilution test method that would give the incorrectly and also with a low reading. So another important parameters which can be calculated within a body plethysmography is a airway resistance. So here the plethysmography can use to measure one is a volume function, another one is airway resistance. So both are can be measured. One is a volume volume and capacity, another one is airway resistance. This is can be obtained during the inhalation of the chest expand, which increase the pressure within the box. While observing, it is called as resistance loop. That means cabin pressure and flows are indicated, which is that means diseases can easily be recognized. If the resistance loop becomes planar, this shows a bad compliance of lungs. A COPD, that is a chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which can easily discovered with the help of plethysmography because this is the unique shape of corresponding resistance loop. The diagram shows the plethysmography which can use it to find out the tidal volume, expiratory reserve volume, inspiratory reserve volume, the total things they are calling as a vital capacity. Who can go for this one plethysmography? That means we can measure the we can measure following terms. One is we can measure the vital capacity, expiratory reserve volume, another one is a inspiratory capacity, which we can't measure so easily, but we can measure in indirect method, but it's a easiest method we can't measure. Okay, the spirometer, it can measure vital capacity, expiratory reserve volume and inspiratory capacity, but plethysmography is we can measure total lung capacity, functional residual capacity and residual volume also with the help of a plethysmography. So here the functional residual capacity, how we can obtain that? We can obtain by the following measurement. One is a multi breathe helium dilution measurement, second one is a nitrogen washed out method, third one is a plethysmography method. So above two or it will provide some complex reading, but body plethysmography is the easiest method they are using in all the hospitals. So here we can say that what is a total lung capacity, TLC, which can be obtained by using the measurement name is called single breathe helium methane measurement. That name is called TL suffix CO versus VA. Second one is a radiographic method, that is CXR or CT scan method. So we know that what is the total body plethysmography. Here it is subjects sit in a air tight box and they are asking a patient to inhale and exhale. At the end of the normal exhalation, the shuttle of mouthpiece is closed and they are asking the patient to make a respiration effectively and with the maximum effort. As a subject, during the inhalation, they expands gas volume in the lung and also lung volume can be increases and box pressure rises and the box volume is decreases. So this is indicated by the Boyle's law, that is PV equal to constant at a constant temperature, because our body temperature is constant. So here let me consider in box, that is